בעזרת השם, שמיטה, לימוד, I think, 6 or 7, maybe. Donc, on est dans le sixième vidéo de la croix de la Shemitah. We'll be starting the chapter 6. On va commencer chapitre 6. So, that's what we're saying. Chapter 6. Chapter 6, les fleurs et les plantes durant la Shemitah. So, what's about the flowers and the plants during the Shemitah? Comme nous l'avons soulevé dans le chapitre précédent, les fleurs peuvent poser un sérieux problème durant la Shemitah. Like we saw in the previous chapter, flowers can be a real problem during the Shemitah. Voici ce qu'il faut retenir. Here's what you have to remind. Les fleurs et les plantes n'ayant pas d'odeur ne sont pas investies de Kedusha. Et toutes les restrictions développées dans le chapitre 5 et 7 ne sont pas en vigueur. The first thing, every plant and flowers which don't have, it doesn't have smells. They don't smell good. They don't have smell. They are not invested, they are not fulfilled by Kedusha. So they are not concerned about the Shemitah rules at all. So to be concerned for the Shemitah rules, flowers and plants have to have smells. Les fleurs et les plantes ayant une bonne odeur et que l'on achète pour profiter de cette odeur sont investies de Kedusha et toutes les restrictions citées dans le chapitre 5 et 7 sont en vigueur. So every plant and flower that you know they smell, they have a good smell, and you buy them, and the purpose to get that smell, they are concerned by the Kedusha of the Shemitah. Les fleurs et les plantes ayant une bonne odeur, mais qui ne sont pas commercialisées dans le but d'en profiter, ne sont pas investies de Kedusha, d'après certains des décisionnaires. Dans d'autres, elles le sont. Il faudra se conduire en conséquence. So he said, the flowers which have good smells, but they are not, you cannot find them in the market. It's like, we all know, you know, we are in the nature. It's not like you have a commerce of that plants or flowers. They say they are not concerned by the Kedusha of the Shemitah. To be concerned that flower to be like buy for that purpose, that smell that we want. And they said some poskim say they are not concerned. Other poskim say yes, they are concerned. So they said because you have some poskim, so rabbi said they are concerned. You have to be careful also about the flowers smelling good, even if they are not in the shuk, in the market. Quoi qu'il en soit, il est interdit durant la Shemitah de faire tous les travaux cités dans le chapitre 2 afin d'obtenir des fleurs. Ces interdictions ne dépendent pas de la Kedusha et de la nature des plantations qui ont poussé. But even though, you have to know that during the Shemitah, it's forbidden to make any kind of work in order to get flowers, to grow flowers, because about flowers concerned being connected to the Shemitah rules. So, like for the fruits and so on, you will not be allowed to grow them. Il est rapporté en fin du chapitre 2 une discussion en ce qui concerne les produits agricoles obtenus de façon interdite. Certains décisionnaires les interdisent et d'autres les permettent. Cependant, en ce qui concerne les fleurs et les plantes, tous les décisionnaires sont d'accord pour affirmer qu'il faut être de rigueur et en interdire l'achat et le profit. Étant donné que ces produits ne sont pas indispensables pour la subsistance de l'homme, certains interdisent même dans de les recevoir en cadeau. Il dit, we saw machloket regarding fruits which have been grown during the Shemitah. Some poskim said, no interest, no use can be done on that kind of food. Some of them say, no, you can maybe sell them. We saw many, we have poskim. They say, regarding the flowers and the plants, there is no machloket. All the poskim are in the same direction. It's forbidden. Because the flowers, there's no purpose for, you know, nutrition or any kind of, that's what man needs to survive, to live. So he said, all the poskim are in the same direction, it's forbidden to get profits from the plants and flowers which have been grown during the Shemitah.
Which have been grown for the smell.
Yeah, for sure. Mais, mis à part cela, il ne faut pas faire de transactions commerciales avec des personnes qui ne respectent pas les lois de la Shemitah. Ceci les encourage dans cette produit et les éloigne d'une remise en question en améliorant leur comportement. Ceci also avoid to have any kind of change working transaction with people who don't respect the Shemitah, meaning they grew up their flowers and they want to sell them no matter what is if it's the Shemitah or not. En conséquence, il faudra être vigilant lors de l'achat de fleurs ou de plantes et en vérifier l'origine afin de ne pas transgresser les interdictions en question. That's why when it comes about you buying flowers, you have to check what are the origins to be sure that you are not going over one halakha saying that you cannot take profit. You cannot take profit by take profit from a product, flowers, fruits which have been grown during the Shemitah. Ils ne sont pas consortés. Il faut l'odeur.
Ils ne pas des fleurs pour Shabbat et
mais qui sont ça. You can buy flowers for Shabbat if there are no smells. There's no problem. You need to have the smell to say that the bouchard de Shemitah is good. You have many others in they grow up naturally.
Yes.
So it's not a work. So
you have the ones that are inside the old city. Yeah, but all these.
Yeah, yeah.
You get those?
In the whole city, because I know that
some
area they water them.
Yeah,
they water. I know that in front of Bethel they water them.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to see what is the behavior. But the best is to go to one of the places where you see that it's natural.
It's a green.
Yeah, there's not no stay there. No.
Yeah.
You see, say that sometimes they cut them, but they grow too high. They cut them. You see. It seems to be that they have a kind of specific treatment. So you have to be careful about that. Chapitre 7. Les fruits de la Shemitah étant investis de Kdusha sont uniquement réservés à la consommation et ne pourront pas servir à des fins différentes. C'est, now let's talk about the consumption, consumption and the use of the fruits from the Shemitah. That the fruits from the Shemitah, they have Kedusha. They are just here to be eaten. No business, no anything else, just here to be eaten. Il est interdit de les cueillir avant qu'ils soient arrivés à maturité, car ceci est considéré comme étant une forme de détérioration de ces fruits. It's forbidden to cueillir, c'est to harvest, non, on peut faire. Yeah, to harvest them before they achieve their maturity. Because if you remove them from the tree before the time, it's like you are damaging them. You are damaging them. It's forbidden. Un légume généralement consommé après avoir subi une cuisson ne pourra pas être consommé sans cuisson. De même, un légume ou un fruit généralement consommé sans cuisson ne pourront être cuits. C'est ça. When you have vegetables, which are usually eaten after being cooked. You will not be able to eat them without cooking them. And if you are the case of vegetables and fruit which not need to be cooked, to be eaten, you will not be allowed to cook them. Meaning, let's say cucumbers, you see. In the Shemitah, you say, okay, this is the cucumbers from the Shemitah, they are forbidden, but I will take them and I will cook them like this. It's not real cucumbers, and I will be able to eat them. Say, no, cucumbers should be eaten natural, rough. So don't start to find a way to get the product from the Shemitah and make something else because you want to take profit on something which is forbidden. Nous avons mentionné l'interdiction de donner à un animal un fruit ou un légume de la Shemitah encore consommable. Cette interdiction est en vigueur même si personne ne veut le manger. Il faut attendre que celui-ci devienne inapte avant de donner aux animaux. So remember about the animals. We said that it's forbidden to give to animals fruits and vegetables from the Shemitah. He said, even if no man wants to eat. He said, if some man don't want to eat, so let it leave it on the table till it will be damaged. If it's damaged, you can give it to the animal. But before, no. Even if it's 10 years, 2 years, I don't know. 10 years. Il faudra redoubler d'attention lorsqu'on se promènera aux zoos ou les jardins publics. Il ne sera pas permis de donner aux bêtes le restant de son repas ainsi que d'autres animaux investis de la couche en question. So be careful when you go to the zoo, where you are used to see animals and maybe you will think that I can give the rest of my fruits or the rest of my vegetables. So don't do that, because probably you will be eating some fruits which are from the Shemitah. You cannot give them to give it to them because you are not you are satisfied. You feel you don't have the place to finish your meal, and you want to give your vegetable and your fruit to animals. Say, don't do that. A soup.
How do you feed the animal?
I think they are, if the, the zoo is kosher zoo, they have to have fruits from the past year, or you order them from foreign countries.
If you have pets yourself, you're like in the middle of the street. At the beginning, won't be sorry.
Yeah, yeah.
In the middle,
it's odd.
You have the time period before they're totally ruined, but after a person will eat them.
Yes.
And this time, then.
Yes, or you wait that they become a little bit damaged, and you give to them.
Like too soft to eat, but the animal may.
Okay, so you're saying the food itself, once it's like almost you can't eat it anymore.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Then you could use it with a sweet.
Exactly. Après, il dit, ceux qui ont l'habitude de ne jamais jeter le pain et de le donner aux oiseaux devront attendre qu'il soit inapte à la consommation de l'homme afin de leur donner. Le fait que le pain soit sec ne permet pas encore de le donner aux animaux. C'est, people who are used to keep bread and to give it to birds. So be careful. You have to be, to wait that bread will not be good for the human being consumption. Because you cannot give something from the shlita. And he said, the bread becoming dry and hard, it's not enough to say that it's not good for being eaten.
You make breadcrumbs with that. Yes. It's
so good for us. Yes, look, but the Swedish bread. Yeah. It's hard. Bien entendu, cette restriction n'est en vigueur que si les ingrédients du pain sont investis dans la culture. So, of course, this is only the case if the ingredients which were used to make the bread are invested with the kedusha of the Shemitah, of course. Dans certains cas, le blé n'est pas d'origine locale, ceci peut éviter bien des problèmes. Il est interdit de détériorer de jeter des fruits de la shmita tant qu'ils sont encore consommables. It's forbidden to put in garbage the fruit of the shmita if it still can be eaten. Cependant, il n'y a aucune obligation de se forcer à les consommer afin d'en éviter une quelconque dégradation. But you're not obliged to eat them in order to avoid they become to avoid that they become damaged. Not obliged. But you have to wait that they become damaged before you throw them in the garbage. L'essentiel étant de ne pas les abîmer de façon directe. So they said, what is the most important? You have to avoid to damage them directly. It should happen by itself. Il faut éduquer les enfants à respecter les fruits de la Shemitah, à les sensibiliser sur l'importance de la culture des fruits. You have to teach the children about the fruit of the Shemitah and to bring them to be very sensitive to the importance of the kedusha of the food from the shmita. Cependant, il ne faudra pas s'empêcher de leur en donner par crainte qu'ils les détériorent comme ils le feraient habituellement. He said, but don't be afraid to give to them that food because you know children they eat food. They don't eat it properly. They eat the part of the food. He said, don't be afraid. It's not a problem. This is their way to eat. So they, it's not called to damage the fruit when they eat like they eat, childish way. Donc il dit, cependant, toutefois, il faudra prendre soin des restants de leur repas et les jeter une fois devenus inaptes. But you have to take care about the rest. If they eat the fruit, you have to take it and to put it in the place till it will be damaged by itself. Même s'il y a une mitzvah de remplir à rabord le verre de Kiddush et le verre de Havdalah, certains décisionnaires pensent qu'il faudra s'abstenir de le faire avec du vin de la Shmita, à moins qu'il ait une assiette sous le verre. Il sera aussi convenable de boire le vin se trouvant dans l'assiette. So he said, even if it's used to fulfill your cup of Kiddush or of Havdalah with wine, even wine going out of the cup, out of the glass, so be careful. Out of the cost, say be careful because this is if the wine is from the Shemitah, it's forbidden to waste wine. So he said, don't fulfill your cup till the top. Try to keep. Or if you have to do it, you have to put a plate under the cup, and after you have to drink the wine which is in the plate. Don't waste the wine from Shemitah. Après il dit, ceux qui ont l'habitude d'éteindre la bougie de Havdalah avec le vin qui reste dans le verre, retour dans l'assiette, devront s'abstenir d'agir de la sorte avec le vin de la Shemitah. The people are used to switch off the light of Abdullah with the wine, which is in the cup. They say during the Shemitah, don't do that. Don't do that.
So like when we go to the store, say the month after next, is the wine in there before Shemitah?
You have to ask to the manager. Mm-hmm. So which wine is from the Shemitah, which one is from last year? Like this, you know exactly.
And so why is it so machmir not to waste any more?
Because the wine will be taken from olive fruits. So the wine itself before the kedusha is holy. So the holiness of the fruit of the Shemitah is the most important aspect, but we want to avoid not to waste it. Are you David? What you want? Perform? Oh, Hashem. After he said, after he did. Il en sera de même pour ceux qui ont l'habitude d'humecter les yeux et de mettre en poche la main d'Avdala. C'est also for people who are used to take the wine of Abdallah and to put in the pocket, or to put in the head, or to put here. He said it's forbidden. Don't do. You don't use the wine for that. Tu n'utilises pas le vin pour ça. Il est interdit de faire subir une quelconque transformation au fruit de la Shemitah respectée dans le cas qui seront détaillés par la suite. C'est it's also forbidden to make any kind of change of shape to the fruit of Shemitah, except in some cases. After he said, écraser, râper, broyer les fruits de la Shemitah. So, écraser is to
smash.
To smash, to râper. Yeah, to smash. No, you know what you do with the
grading.
To smash, to grade, and to squeeze the fruit of the Shemitah. Les fruits et légumes qui sont habituellement écrasés, broyés, pourront être écrasés, broyés durant la Shemitah. C'est fruits and vegetables, which are usually that the common way is to squash them, to squeeze them, and to grate them. It's permitted to do it during the Shemitah. Ceci est valable pour les pommes de terre. It's the case of for the potatoes, carrots, betterave. Beetroot? You know beetroot?
Beetroot. Beet is celery.
Beetroot.
Yeah, it's celery. Yeah, celery. Garlic, onion, avocado, tomato, apple, and banana.
Limon.
Everything, yes, he said, and so on. So meaning that if you are used to do it, you can do it. If you are not used, it's not. Now let's say squeezing the fruit of the Shemitah, presser les fruits de la Shemitah. Il dit, il faut savoir que faire un jus de fruits pendant la Shemitah peut poser certains problèmes. You have to know that to do the juice during the Shemitah can bring problems. En effet, une partie du fruit sera jetée alors qu'elle pourrait être consommée. En effet, une partie de la pulpe retenue dans le presse-agrumes. C'est why? Because one part of the fruit which have been squeezed could be used to be eaten. You take just the juice, but what about the pulp? The pulp. So what's that? Be careful. Il dit, le jus peut être d'importance moindre par rapport au fruit lui-même. Il y aura donc une dégradation du fruit, ce qui est problématique. C'est why? Also, the juice is in a lower level compared to the fruit itself. So it's considered like damaged, because the fruit is like, and you squeeze it to get the juice. But the juice is a lower level than the fruit itself. So you damage the fruit, tu abîmes le fruit. Il dit, il y aura donc ce qui est problématique. Ce sujet fait l'objet de discussions entre dictionnaires. Voici ce qui peut ressortir des différentes opinions. So say we have many machlokot with the poskim. Here is the main thing to keep in mind. That's it, and we finish. Et voici la dernière chose qu'il faut savoir. Il dit, les raisins et les olives ne sont pas sujets à discussion. Il sera permis d'en faire du vin et de l'huile. C'est grapes and olives, they are not in the discussion. It's permitted to you to do wine and oil. You can squeeze. It's not considered that you downgrade it. No, it's upgraded. Because wine is other than grape. And olive oil is other than olives. Donc on n'a pas abîmé. Parce que le vin, c'est plus grand que la grappe de raisin. Et l'huile d'olive, elle est plus grande que l'olive lui-même. So we upgrade. On a augmenté. Donc, il n'y a pas de problème.
Oh,
Non, parce que quand on, tout à l'heure, il disait le problème, c'est qu'on a abîmé. Si je prends une pomme et que je sors du jus, en fait, j'ai le jus qui sort de la pomme, c'est un niveau en dessous du fruit originel. Parce que le fruit, il est plus grand. Le jus, c'est qu'une partie du fruit. Mais par contre, si je fais du vin ou de l'huile, j'ai amélioré le fruit. C'est-à-dire que je lui ai passé un niveau au-dessus. La valeur intrinsèque du vin, elle est plus forte que la valeur d'une grappe de raisin. La valeur intrinsèque de l'huile d'olive, elle est plus grande que l'olive. Alors que le jus de pomme, ce n'est pas sûr qu'il coûtera moins plus cher que la pomme lui-même. C'est ça qu'il dit. Après, il dit, en ce qui concerne les pommes, les oranges, les pamplemousses, les citrons, la majorité pense qu'il sera permis d'en faire du jus étant donné le fait qu'il est habituel de les consommer de cette façon. C'est regarding the apples, the orange and the lemon, most of the people think that yeah, it's permitted to squeeze them. Why? Because this is the regular way that people do in their life. You squeeze to get the juice. Certains permettent également de faire du jus de carotte, du jus de banane. But some people give authorization to do carrot juice and green pomegranate juice because it's not so useful like orange. No? So he said, last point, se rapporter au passage suivant pour savoir comment traiter les raisons de fruits. So he said, tomorrow, next chapter, we'll see what do you do with the rest of the fruit that you have just squeezed. Demain. Amen. Amen.